Hey everyone, welcome to today's video. Today we're going to talk about a powerful framework for organizing your life, the Para Method. It's been getting a lot of attention lately. If you're looking for an easy-to-maintain system that can help you get your life organized, and you want some practical tips, keep watching. I'll show you how to apply the Para Method in TickTick. Para stands for Project, Area, Resource, and Archive. It's a method introduced by Tiago Forte in his book. The idea is to divide your life into four main categories, each with subcategories, to help you stay organized. P, project. This refers to a series of tasks with clear goals and deadlines. It's something you're actively working on and need to focus your time and energy to complete. Examples: completing a course, renovating your bathroom, or planning a promotional campaign. A, area. These are ongoing responsibilities in your life that require continuous attention, like software development, customer support, or personal areas such as health, family, finances, etc. R, resource. These are topics or interests you're exploring, like reading, photography, or learning a new language. A, archive. This is where you store completed projects or inactive areas, resources. With its simple folder and list structure, applying the Para framework in TickTick is easy. Let's start by setting up project, area, and resource as folders. Why no need for an archive folder? Because in TickTick, inactive lists can be archived automatically, and they'll show up in the archived lists folder. No need to create it yourself. Now, let's add lists under each folder. On desktop, right-click the folder. Select Add List, and name your list. You can also add an emoji if you like. Or you can create a list first and drag it into another list to quickly create a folder. Once your system is set up, here's how you can use it. The Project and Area folders will be where you manage your tasks. I capture all my tasks in the appropriate folder, set clear deadlines and priorities, and keep everything organized. This helps me stay on top of things and avoid procrastination. If a task in a specific area is related to a task in a project, you can quickly link them by adding a link. Next, we have the resource folder, where you can add lists to help you track your interests or hobbies. More importantly, this is where you can save notes. You can set these topic lists as notes lists for easy note-taking. You can collect related books, articles, videos, or jot down your thoughts. If you prefer tracking your personal experiences, you can create templates for easy reuse. The key here is to keep capturing and organizing your resources into lists so they're easy to find later. Finally, the archive folder. As mentioned earlier, you don't need to create an archive folder manually. When a project is completed, like finishing your bathroom renovation, you can simply right-click it and choose Archive. It will be moved to the Archive Lists folder automatically. This keeps your to-do list clean and free of outdated tasks. With the Para method, you can organize your tasks and goals more efficiently, ensuring that short-term projects, long-term responsibilities, and resources are all handled properly. If you found this method helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe. See you in the next video.